Hello, Meg here from PMTVUK, and last year around October time I had the absolute pleasure of visiting Barnes & Mullins. Barnes & Mullins is home to many different beloved brands, but one of the brands they do look after is Faith Guitars. I've been a huge fan of Faith Guitars since I got into acoustic guitars, really. There's lots of things about the Faith brand that make them unique and desirable. And when we went to visit Barnes & Mullins, I had the joy of chatting to Patrick James Eggle himself. In this video, I'm going to dive into a little bit about the history of Faith guitars, some cool facts you might not know about them, touch on their main body shapes and sizes, what they mean, and the different woods they use. I was really inspired by my chat with Patrick, and there was lots of different insights that he shared with me that I'd love to share with you in a bit more detail. Before I do dive into this video though, if you want to see any more videos like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button. So Faith Guitars was born in 2002 with a group of guitar builders and luthiers alongside the world-renowned Patrick James Eggle. Patrick James Eggle is well known for his electric guitars, and if you are into guitars then I'm sure you have heard of his bespoke brand of electric guitars with high specs, interesting wood choices and really impressive craftsmanship. They're all hand designed in his workshop in Shropshire, and the ethos of this wanted to be taken over to the Faith brand. With his 3 decades of experience, he was the perfect man to get involved in this job. And back in October when I did visit Barnes & Mullins, I did have the joy of chatting to him about his guitar journey and how it began. One thing I do remember him sharing with me was that his guitar journey began at the age of 15 when he started building his first guitars. Incredibly impressive, there is no way I would have been able to build a guitar at 15 years old. He says about himself on his website and on the Faith Guitars website that if you were to describe his guitar building, it would be obsessive. I can see what he means with this point, as the attention to detail, the craftsmanship and the high quality guitars are right at the core of all of his designs. This is no exception with Faith Guitars, with him being a pioneer in building this brand. All of his ethoses from that world-renowned electric brand was taken over to Faith Guitars. Over the next decade, from 2002, it gradually began to build, and by the time we got to 2015, Faith was being introduced into the US market. This was after it had been named UK's best guitar of the year for a few years in a row. I'm not surprised, the specs of these guitars really do sit them above some of the other competitors in the same sort of price points. I will dive into why that is shortly if you haven't actually heard too much about this acoustic guitar brand and you want to know why. But sticking with a brief history of this brand, that's where it began. Over time, Faith have obviously expanded their models and used different woods, for example. But the core ideas that were there at the beginning and birth of this brand have always remained with it throughout. Whether it is an acoustic or an electric guitar, Patrick James Eggle's desire seems to be to create a high quality, well playing, good sounding, all round guitar. With the UK base set up in Shropshire, they partnered with some satellite workshops over in Java, Indonesia, where the guitar builders and luthiers over there would work by hand, keeping that hand-built, hand-quality process in the Faith guitar building. It seems one thing they wanted to stray away from when creating these guitars is making fast-paced, factory-produced guitars without that hand-quality touch. So this is something that is still very important in their process of building these acoustic guitars. Another thing that is very important for Faith is keeping a commitment to sustainability when it comes to sourcing the woods and materials needed for their guitars. The Engelmann spruce that they generally use for most of the models in the Faith range is sourced from tonewood merchants in North America, and this applies also to the cedar tops that you see occasionally on something like this Naked Venus over here, with a cedar top and mahogany back and sides. One thing that is a benefit of working over in Indonesia in the factories there is they have access to the Indonesian mahogany. This wood is also obviously sourced sustainably and, as I said, using only Forest Stewardship Council certified materials. In a world where sustainability is becoming more and more a prominent discussion in every avenue, not just guitar building, then Faith Guitars have definitely been doing their best bit with this for many years.
Thank you.
looking now at the guitars themselves and what makes them stand out and what makes them so unique. If you're not too clued up on what each one means, then this could be a little confusing, but it's nice and easy. I'm going to run through each of the main models now. You have the Mercury, which is the Parlor. This generally tends to be a spruce and mahogany pairing, so spruce on the top and mahogany on the back and sides. The one I've got with me today is the Naked Mercury. There's also a high gloss version which has an arm bevel cut out of it, which is super comfortable to play. So that's your parlor guitar. This would be a great bluesy machine or anyone looking for something that's got that more thinner, twangier, smaller bodied acoustic sound. So then we have the Venus body shape, which is probably the most infamous and, dare I say it, best-selling body shape. It's the Grand Auditorium, so their 15-inch bout version, and it's a nice, small and comfortable size to play. It is still a full-scale guitar, but because of that smaller auditorium body, it tends to feel really comfortable for a range of different genres. Up from that, you have the Neptune, which is the slightly bigger cutaway version, or what you might call a baby jumbo. These obviously tend to have a little bit more bass and resonance than the smaller Venus version. If even more bass and resonance is what you're after, then you could take a look at the Jupiter. This is the jumbo body. Then from there, they have two different dreadnought styles. You've got the slope shoulder dreadnought, the Mars, and the standard box style dreadnought, the Saturn. Both of these guitars come in different woods, as we'll go into the different woods shortly, but generally in the Naked series, these would come as a spruce top and mahogany back and sides pairing. Then of course you have the mini Nomads, where you can get a mini Neptune and a mini Saturn. These are three-quarter style guitars which are perfect for travelling, so if you're ever in the lookout for an all solid wood guitar for travelling or being on the road that is nice and small, then the mini Nomad range is definitely the one to check out. And the latest body size to join the family is Earth. This came with the design of the Legacy series, and Earth is a slightly smaller Grand Auditorium when compared to the Venus. This would be good if you really want to get some nuance from those highs and mids, as it has slightly less bass room in the slightly smaller body. So that's all of the body shapes and sizes. If you were ever wondering what all those different planets meant, then now you know. And as I said on a few of those, they come in lots of different variations. One thing that is very interesting about Faith is their choice of some more exotic woods. A wood that has been an amazing addition to their acoustic guitars is Trembesi. This is another Indonesian native wood, and it's got such wonderful tonal characteristics. It really pairs nicely with these guitars. When you pair it with an Engelmann spruce top, it really sits somewhere in between mahogany and rosewood. It behaves almost like a walnut type of wood would do on an acoustic guitar. It's not overly bright and it's not overly bassy. It's somewhere in the middle, which gives you so much scope for how that guitar is going to expand in tone as it's played in. Faith guitars are so well known for their crisp and clarity, and Trembesi would make a really interesting wood in the recording studio. If you wanted to play something quite fingerpick heavy, this would really help those nuanced sounds to come through. On the high gloss series, they tend to use rosewood as a back and sides wood. As rosewood is an endangered wood and has been for around a decade or so now, you have to be quite careful with how much you use this for, and guitar brands tend to use rosewood as a higher spec wood on the back and sides. That being said, it does remain an absolutely stunning tone wood choice for acoustic guitars. Rosewood has that rich and bassy resonance, and when you pair it with the brightness of a spruce top, it's just a fantastic pair. On our visit last year, we did get to play some, and one of my favourite Faith guitars of all time is the 3-ply Rosewood High Gloss. It looks incredible on the back if you haven't seen it before, with that 3-split rosewood. You have the added bonus of it being a slightly more ethical way to use rosewood. But the High Gloss series are absolutely stunning, and with that slightly thicker layer of lacquer on the wood, as the High Gloss pertains to, you get slightly more protection against the elements. Another range that has been incredibly popular over the last few years is the Blood Moons, and I can see why, because they are absolutely stunning looking guitars. And interestingly, these guitars use Trembessie as the top and back and sides wood. This makes for a very lively and clear sounding guitar with very, very pronounced highs and mids. Again, this would be a very interesting guitar to take to the studio, as well as a great guitar for cutting through a live mix. We also have the Blue Moon, which I've got with me today, and that uses Java Mango, another interesting wood that Faith have discovered and used from Indonesia. Java Mango behaves similar to Trembessie, but I would say with a little bit more of a scooped bottom. Slightly more bassy wood than Trembessie, but those exotic woods tend to have very similar characteristics and sit in between mahogany and rosewood. You also, of course, have all mahogany guitars, so I have the Nexus All Mahogany with me, but you have the Naked Venus All Mahogany. These guitars I find play a little differently to how you would expect a standard mahogany. Due to the nature of Faith's build quality and the use of all solid tone woods, they still have quite a bright character, even though you still have that standard mellow mahogany tone. There's just something in that Faith shine that I really love, especially as a more folk-leaning guitarist who tends to do a lot of picking and in-between strumming. I find their all mahogany guitars have slightly more liveliness to them than some of the more standard mahoganies you'd get that are quite earthy and mellow. So that's all of the main tone woods that they use with their guitars and where they tend to source them with. Another thing that plays a very important part in their series and something to get familiar with if you are wondering is how they use lacquer. The Naked series, if you haven't already figured, is a nod to using as little as possible on these guitars. So you'll notice these guitars have a very simple design. There's not too many flourishes on them, not too many details, and they're using just a 2-stage satin finish. Although it is known that lacquer finishes do help to protect your guitars, there's something Patrick James Eggle noticed when playing and designing acoustic guitars, that satin finish guitars tend to play a bit more lively. This would be down, I would assume, to the wood being able to move a bit more because it doesn't have that heavy finish on it. You will obviously want to take care of these guitars as you would with any acoustic, as it is a little bit more susceptible to the elements, but he is right, there is a certain liveliness and resonance in these Naked series guitars that give them quite a lot of boldness and punch. Plus, that understated design is really quite nice and makes these guitars look quite classy. There is the Natural, which uses a high gloss top with that 2-stage satin finish on the back and sides. And then when you get up to the high gloss range and some of the more unique models, they'll be using a high gloss heavy lacquer. When I say heavy though, this isn't actually a heavy finish, as something that they try and avoid is using a heavy high gloss lacquer on all the guitars though, so they're still giving the wood enough room to breathe. And if you haven't figured by now, one of the most amazing things about Faith guitars is that they use all solid tone woods, no matter what guitar it is, no matter what the price point. By using that 2-stage satin finish on the Naked range, this obviously makes it a little bit more cost efficient to build a guitar with those solid woods. Most brands will tend to stray away from solid tone woods until you get up to the slightly higher price point. So for me, this is one of the biggest selling points and unique things about Faith guitars. And the best thing about that is the more you play it in over time, the better these guitars are going to sound. An in-depth look through everything to do with Faith guitars, why they started, who designed them, and all the different models in the series. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did making it. I love playing Faith guitars, so I've also enjoyed getting to play some of the different models for you today. If you have a Faith guitar, let me know in the comments which one you have and why you love it so much. If you don't have a Faith but you're now interested in trying one, let me know as well. I'd love to know any additional facts or interesting things that you might know about this brand that I didn't already. But thanks so much for watching. Make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to our channel. If you want, you can come find us over on our social media at Play Music Today. I've been Meg and I will see you all in a video very soon.